I decided if I was going to come to Indiana Tech, I was going to be a different kind of instructor. I was really going to focus on connecting with students, teaching the students the theory that they needed, and also the practical applications.
Very practically, what that looks like is smaller class sizes. So my class sizes are the 8 to 10 up to maybe 20. And that's backed up with, we have 18 hours of office hours every week. I'm sitting in my office waiting for students to come in to talk about anything. It doesn't just have to be with the classroom.
In the College of Engineering, we have ABET accreditation for mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, and biomedical engineering. ABET is the top accrediting board for engineering in the United States and probably in the world.
Another thing that is a very different approach at Indiana Tech, I think, than some other universities is we try and make sure they have a lot of lab experience in the engineering department. All engineering programs are going to have laboratory courses, but in our laboratory courses we try to get them not just exposure to measurements and exposure to some of the devices that you'll be used, but I like to actually assign projects that are, you know, realistic projects.
Those projects, as project-based learning, help students to work together in a group and be hands-on with the material or the product that they're creating. Engineering students at Indiana Tech are, to me, stand out because I know that they've had a lot of experiences working in groups, working on projects, doing lab experiments to help them understand the material, and I think that prepares them well for industry.
First thing I'll tell a high school student is study, study, study. Get all the math you can possibly get. I honestly believe that the critical thinking skills you learn in math courses will help you with engineering courses.
The type of knowledge base that students should have coming in, they need to be problem solvers and critical thinkers. Those two things are really the essence of engineering. Regardless of flavor, they're going to need to figure out, there's a problem here, how do I solve it? And they need to think critically about that. They need to observe, listen to people, and then kick in those problem-solving skills to solve the problem.
Part of the growth of Indiana Tech has involved an increasing number of international students. So I think if we can expose students to different ideas, different cultures, again, it makes them that much more competitive in the marketplace.
In the Fort Wayne area, we have lots of large companies, BAE Systems, Fort Wayne Metals, General Motors, Raytheon, Harris Corporation, and the list goes on. We have a lot of employers that want our engineering students.
Indiana Tech, I think, continues to serve students even beyond their graduation. We really strive to keep in touch with our alumni on a personal level just to see how they're doing, but then also they want to give back to the university because of the experiences they've had here, so they want to provide opportunities for other students here as well.